Next, new intelligence reports on the war in Afghanistan, and to Margaret Warner.
Tomorrow, the White House presents its long-awaited review of how much progress has been made in the Afghan war since the president's surge of U.S. forces there. Today, the New York Times and Los Angeles Times reported on two classified national intelligence assessments, one of Afghanistan, one on Pakistan, that have gone into that review. The NIEs represent the collective view of 16 U.S. intelligence agencies. They were said to offer a gloomy view of the state of play, especially when it comes to Pakistan's unwillingness to take out Afghan militant sanctuaries on its territory. For more, we go to Elizabeth Bumiller, a Pentagon correspondent for The New York Times. And Elizabeth, welcome back. Now, there have been a lot of intelligence assessments all along the process of this war. What makes these special?
Because they're current or relatively current, and because one is focused on Afghanistan, one is focused on Pakistan, and because right now it's the moment for reviewing Afghanistan. And they're important because, again, they represent all the views of all these intelligence agencies with, I would say, a very heavy input from the CIA and from the Defense Intelligence Agency. They're the main drafting agencies.
So the headline on your piece and the lead was essentially more negative in tone, certainly, than what we've been hearing from Secretary Gates or General Petraeus, the commander of U.S.
Right.
forces there lately. How so?
They are more focused on the problem of Pakistan. I mean, there's not... Overall, there are large areas of agreement. I mean, the military agrees. Pakistan is a big problem. It's the analysis that there will be a very limited chance of success without Pakistan flushing out insurgents in its border region with Afghanistan. And the military says, yes, that's a problem, but we think we can do it without Pakistan, which is an interesting shift because all along they've been trying to push Pakistan to get rid of those insurgents, and now they're saying, well, we don't think it's going to happen. We're going to just press forward.
One thing I just wanted to clarify is to what degree you've actually seen these
right.
NIEs.
Right. I made clear in the story that I have not seen them. However, they were a number of American officials described them to me and to my colleagues, Mark Bazzetti, David Sanger. So we got descriptions from a group of people.
So back to the findings. I want to get to Pakistan in a minute, but let me just ask, first of all, do they dispute what General Petraeus and Secretary Gates have been saying about, at least in military terms, that U.S. and Afghan forces have been regaining some of the momentum against the Taliban, especially in the south?
No one disputes that. I think that is generally agreed upon now in Helmand province and in Kandahar province, where the extra forces have been concentrated. There are 20,000 Marines in Helmand province alone. Now, you send 20,000 Marines almost anywhere, there's going to be a change. And there has been, even in places like Marja, which was considered a failure by some accounts 6 months ago. It's now relatively stable in parts of it. And there's been some success around Kandahar and the districts around Kandahar, which is the sort of, you know, spiritual home of the Taliban. The question is, how sustainable is that? Can this be, how many more marches do you need to do, as mm-hmm. one White House official said to me not too long ago. And can the Afghan forces do it on their own once the U.S. leaves?
And that takes us back to what role Pakistan is and will play. So tell us a little bit more about what these NIEs at least say about Pakistan's role, how extensively they're assisting the Afghan Taliban and other insurgents who are in the border area and cross over and attack U.S. and Afghan
Well, actually, forces. I don't think it's just the NIEs. I think it's the entire Obama administration right now acknowledges what a big problem this is that the Pakistani intelligence service is using these proxy insurgent groups on the border to they go right across the border. You know, you had commanders were saying that last week in the eastern part of Afghanistan, that they go right across the border, they plant homemade bombs, they attack American forces, and then they go right back across to Pakistan for rest
and
resupply,
relaxation,
refitting, and you know, we're only at war officially in Afghanistan.
So do these reports, or at least what you know about them, say whether the Pakistani military at the highest levels is just allowing this to happen, or whether there are rogue elements that are assisting them, or whether, in fact, the Pakistani military at the highest levels is in engaged in this?
I can't answer that question. They certainly say that there are rogue elements within the Pakistani intelligence service. They also say that there's been basically lip service paid by General Kayani, who's the head of the military in Pakistan. You know, General Petraeus just last week praised Kayani for saying, yes, we acknowledge this is a problem. But that's basically what the Pakistanis have said for 2 or 3 years.
So now you said that General Petraeus thinks he can, quote, win the conflict. I shouldn't use the word win,
right,
because he doesn't. But get to a reasonable conclusion without assistance from Pakistan. What's his rationale?
Well, I don't know that he's come out and said that explicitly. But what I hear from military sources is that right now we're doing it. The question is,
because we're degrading Taliban.
We're killing Taliban or capturing Taliban on the border, in the border region.
And building up the Afghan.
Yeah, and the strategy right now is, it's not perfect, is that to continue doing this to the point that in a number of years the Afghan forces can at least contain and manage the problem on their own. That's a big, big, big if.
So very briefly, we only have a couple seconds left. What's the headline going to be out of the review tomorrow?
Some progress, more needs to be done.
But meanwhile, stay the course tactically,
right,
strategically?
Right, absolutely, because the next big assessment will come in the summer, and that, the White House is saying, is the more important assessment of it, what troops are pulled out.
And when.
And when, yeah.
Elizabeth Bumiller, New York Times, thanks.
Thank you.